should never have lied. That was a real mistake.
I have some very definite ideas of right and wrong, and it's always wrong to lie.
There, he was afraid.
Well, of course he was afraid. He cheated during the Latin exam. He knew he'd be found out. He knew he'd be punished. But lying would have been 100 times worse.
Alan! Alan!
Oh, Lord, that's my mother.
Oh, here you are. Oh, do forgive me. I thought I heard the doorbell, but I wasn't sure. I was out in the garden, you see. Do forgive me. Alan, won't you introduce me to your friend?
No, I'm sorry. This is Christopher Morecambe.
How do you do, Christopher?
Well, how do you do, Mrs. Turin?
Oh, I'm delighted to meet you at long last. Alan's talked so much about you, and I kept saying, do invite Christopher down for the weekend. Never expecting for a moment that he would. No matter what we say, he always endeavours to keep his dear friends to himself. I think perhaps he's ashamed of us. Did you have a comfortable journey?
Oh, very much, thank you. The train was almost empty.
Oh, good. Do sit down, won't you? And sit down over here by me.
Thank you.
Can you tell me that your family has a place in town?
Well, it's only very small. Near Victoria Station, actually. My mother uses it as a studio.
Studio?
For her sculpture. She makes sculptures and so forth.
How exciting!
Well, not really.
Oh, I think it would be rather exciting to have a mother who's an artist.
It's only a hobby, really. She spends most of her time looking after the goats.
What goats?
We have a goat farm at home.
Near Victoria Station?
No, in the country. Our real home is in Worcestershire.
I love Worcestershire. The Garden of England.
No, it's Kim's mother.
I often wish we'd been able to spend more time in this country, but of course, that was impossible. Has Alan told you about our travels?
No.
Ah, well. My husband was in the Indian Civil Service. He's retired now, ill health. But for years, we roamed around India. Swadhin Madras, Kapil, Chhatrapur. Alan was very nearly born in Chhatrapur.
But how can you be nearly born anywhere? It doesn't make any sense.
Oh, Alan.
But look at it logically.
I do wish you wouldn't say things like that.
Well, like what?
You know how much it annoys me. Alan has such an unruly streak in his nature. I should think you're much more level-headed.
Well,
anyway, I'm glad you two have become such firm friends. Without a steady influence, it's all too easy for a clever boy to become a mere intellectual crank.
Well, thank you, Mother.
Oh, I didn't mean it unkindly. It's a very real danger. How long have you been a chairman?
A year longer than Turin. Alan.
And are you enjoying it?
Very much.
Choosing the right school is so tremendously important, don't you think? And I'm very impressed.
But it's not that wonderful.
Yes, it is.
But no.
What's wrong with it?
Well, our headmaster doesn't take mathematics as seriously as the subject.
I can't believe that.
No, it's true. Do you know what he said the other day? He said, this room stinks of mathematics. That's what he said, looking straight at me. So he said, go out and get a disinfectant spray.
Joking.
No, he's serious. Though he hates anything to do with mathematics and science. Well, you know what he once said? And he was serious. He said, the reason why the Germans lost the Great War is because they regard science more important than religion.
Well, the teaching of mathematics is not the only way to judge the quality of the school.
No, it is as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, Alan. I gather you share this enthusiasm for science and science.
Oh, very much. And it's wonderful having someone like Alan to work with. Has he told you about our experiments?
Yes, a little. Wasn't it something to do with iodine?
Iodates. And sulfites.
We were trying to examine the time delay in the recombination of ions.
Yes, well, it was all far beyond my grasp. Fascinating. touching on with my glass. It was the same effect theory Alan was telling me about. Well, what was it? You know, the man with the Jewish name.
Einstein.
I didn't understand a word of it. Not one word. Does your family understand these things?
Well, yes.
Morgan's brother is a scientist. Though they've got their own laboratory at home.
Really?
And he's got his own telescope.
Really? How splendid.
Oh, it's tremendous, Mrs. Turing. Absolutely terrific. The other night, did I tell you? I actually saw one of Jupiter's satellites coming out from eclipse. It's amazing.
Oh gosh,
it's a perfectly clear night. Absolutely cloudless. I felt like I was wandering through the universe. Jupiter, Sirius, Betelgeuse, the Andromeda Nebula. That's quite overwhelming, the hugeness of creation.
Ah, terrific.
Your sound's very thrilling. I hope you don't frighten your family the way Alan does.
Frighten how?
We woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning last Thursday. I woke up. We heard footsteps on the stairs. I was convinced we had burglars. My husband was on the point of telephoning the police. And you realised it was only Alan.
I was mapping the constellation of the fixed stars.
I sometimes wish you'd take up stamp collecting or model trains. Brother. Let's have some tea, shall we? Do wash your hands, they're covered in ink. Oh, has Alan told you about my grandfather's cousin? He was a scientist. He invented the electron.
No, he didn't invent it, Mother. The electrons exist, you can't invent them.
Well, he discovered them or found them or whatever it is. He was a fellow of the Royal Society. Very distinguished.
No, I'm sorry. One can't choose one's own mother.
She's all right.
You know what I wish?
What?
I wish this were my house. My own house. So we could live here, you and I. So we could have our own rooms, our own laboratories. So we could work together, share everything. What a wonderful life that would be.
Yes it would.
Come along, Christopher.
I'd better go.
Oh, Chris,